Hi, myself Biramesh, Assistant Professor in Mechanical Engineering Department, WITS Warangal. Welcome to WITS Connect. Okay, today class we have discussed about the some of the problems of higher calorific value and lower calorific value. Okay, in this one of the problem of the higher calorific value. Okay, in this one what will be given as find the higher calorific value of the fuel whose composition by mass. Okay, here given as by mass. Okay, is as follows: carbon 91%, hydrogen 3%, sulfur 0.8%, remainder is ash. Okay, in this problem this data will be given. Okay, first we will write the given data. What will be given in the problem? First we will write the in this data, first composition of 1 kg of fuel. Okay, first given data. Okay, composition of 1 kg of fuel. Okay, first in the composition this 1 kg of fuel this one. In this one first one what will be given as carbon is given. Okay, carbon 91% it will be converted 0.91 kg. okay, it will be converted into kg, 0.91 kg. next hydrogen is 3% is 0.03 kg. okay, in converted into kg. okay, next what will be given? Sulfur is equals to 0.8%, it will be converted into kg, 0.008 kg. okay, here these values are given. Okay, remainder is ash. Then in this one we will find out the higher calorific value. Okay, find out higher calorific value ne find out jale. Okay, from the Dulang's formula higher calorific value for equation is, that is 33,800 carbon composition plus
144,000 into H2 minus O2 by 8 into plus 9270 sulfur kilojoule per kg. Okay, this is the formula of Dulang's formula of higher calorific value. In this one carbon is given and hydrogen is given. Okay, hydrogen is given, oxygen is not given. Okay, na O2 is 0, oxygen is not given, and sulfur also given. Okay, these all values substitute in this equation, then where HCV equals to 33,800 into C, how carbon is given as C value, that is how much? 0.91. okay, 0.91 plus 144,000 into H2. How much value H2 is given? Hydrogen, that is 0.03. okay, plus 9270 into sulfur is 0.008. okay, in this one higher calorific value is equals to, in this one higher calorific value we get the value of 35152. okay, 35152 kilojoule per kg. okay, 35152 kilojoule per kg of heat is higher calorific value is obtained. Okay, in this manner we solve the another problem of higher calorific value and lower calorific value. This is another problem of lower calorific value. Find the lower calorific value per kg of coal. A sample of coal has the following compositions by mass. Okay, following compositions by mass: carbon 80%, hydrogen 5%, oxygen 6%, nitrogen 2.5%, sulfur 1.5%, ash is 5%. Okay, first of all you write the what will be given in the problem. Okay, first we'll write the given data. Okay, what will be given as in this one? Carbon equals to 80%, 0.80 kg
okay, 80% it will be converted into kgs, 0.80 kg, and next hydrogen that is equals to 5% equals to 0.05 kg, and next to what will be given, oxygen equals to 6%, 0.06 kg, and next what will be given, nitrogen is given as 2.5% equals to 0.025 kg. Next sulfur equals to 1.5%, 0.015 kg, and next remaining is ash is given, okay, remainder is ash, okay, ash 5%, 0.05 kg is given, okay. And next what will be find out in this one, we will find out the lower calorific value, okay, na lower calorific value ni manam find out cheyali indu nunchi, okay. First of all, what will be, we will find out the lower calorific value, we know the formula of LCV, lower calorific value is equals to HCV, higher calorific value minus 9H2 into 2466, okay, we know this formula, okay. In this one we will find out the higher calorific value, we know the H2, okay, hydrogen value manaku telusu, first of all find out the higher calorific value from the Dulang's formula, okay, HCV equals to 33800C plus 14300 H2 minus O2 by 8 and plus 9270 sulfur S, okay, this is the, we know this equation from the Dulang's formula, okay. Substitute all these values in this equation, carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, sulfur, okay. First 33800 carbon value is 0.80 plus 14300 H2 value, we know that H2 hydrogen, that is how much given, 0.05 minus 0.06 hydrogen value, okay, 0.06 hydrogen, where is the hydrogen, okay, here oxygen, okay, oxygen value 0.06, and next 8 plus 9270 into H sulfur value is given as 0.015. Okay, from this value we get the higher calorific value, okay. In this one higher calorific value manaku enta vastundante 33, okay, 33299.05 kilojoule per kg, okay, 33299 kilojoule per kg. So then substitute HCV values in this equation, we get the LCV value, okay, HCV that is 33,299.05 minus 9 into how much, H2 is 0.05 hydrogen, okay, 0.05, okay, into 2466, then we get the lower calorific value, that is 32189, okay, 32189.35 kilojoule per kg, okay. In this manner we find out the lower calorific value, okay. And next problem is solve the composition of fuels, okay. This is the another problem of fuels of combustion. In this one, the mass of air to be supplied for the combustion of 1 kg of fuel, okay, 1 kg of fuel burn kavadaniki enta amount of mass of air pampistunnadu ante, the fuel is containing 83% carbon, 5% hydrogen, 0.2% sulfur, 2% oxygen, and rest being incombustible, okay. Assume 35% excess air is to be used, okay, 1 kg of fuel burning avadaniki ekku inka 35% of excess air kuda use chestunnadu, okay. In this one first we will write the given data, what will be given in this problem, okay. First what will be given this problem, mass of
constituency is 1 kg of fuel. Okay, 1 kg of fuel is given. Okay, in this one fuel, carbon is EIT3%, that is 0.83 kg. Okay, 0.83 kg. Next, hydrogen is how much? 5% is given, 0.05 kg. okay, and next what will be given? Sulfur is given how much? 0.2%. okay, 0.2%, 0.002 kg. next what will be given? Oxygen is 2%, 0.02 kg. okay, 0.02 kg. okay, these remaining is incombustible. Assume 35% excess air is required. Find out how much mass of air to be supplied to the combustion of 1 kg of air. Okay, first we will find out theoretical air required. Okay, we know the formula of theoretical air required formula, that is 100 by 23 into 8 by 3 C plus carbon and 8H2 plus S minus O2. Okay, we know this formula as earlier session. Okay, in this one carbon is given, hydrogen is given, sulfur is given, oxygen also given. Then substitute all these values in this equation, then we get the answer of theoretical air required. Here carbon is 0.83 and plus 8 into hydrogen, how much is given? 0.05 plus sulfur, how much is given? Sulfur 0.002 minus oxygen, how much is given? 0.02. okay, in this one we get the theoretical air required value is 11.284. okay, 11.284 kg. okay, 11.284 kg of air is required. Okay, in this one how much amount of excess air is to be used? That is 35% of excess air is used. Air supplied is 35% excess. Okay, 35% is excess supply isthunnadu. Okay, next actual air to be supplied, asal actual ga enta air supply isthunnam. Okay, actual air to be supplied, okay, how much actual air is to be supplied? That is 11.284 into 1.35. okay, actual 11.284, that is the 100%. Excess how much amount of air is supplied? 35% air is supplied. Then total is 135%. Then we will come 1.35, then multiply 1.35, then we will get the how much actual air is supplied. Okay, adding of 35% of excess air. Okay, now excess air 35% nu kuda add chesthe manaku total enta amount of air anedi supply aitundi 1 kg of fuel ni burn cheyadaniki. Okay, that is 1.35, we get the value answer of, that is 15.234 kg of air is required. kg per kg. okay, kg per kg of air is required. Okay, kg per kg of fuel, kg per kg fuel. Okay, in this manner we solve another problem of solid fuels. The gravimetric analysis of a solid fuel is as follows: carbon 86%, hydrogen 8%, oxygen 4%, nitrogen 1%, sulfur 1%. Okay, and determine the theoretical air required and fuel ratio. Okay, first of all write the what will be given in this problem. Given data, okay, first carbon equals to 86%, that is 0.86 kg. okay, and next hydrogen hydrogen is 8% 0.08 kg and oxygen is 4% 0.04 kg and next nitrogen is 1% 0.01 kg. Okay, these and next what will be given as sulfur. Okay, sulfur equals to 1% 0.01 kg. Okay, these data will be given in this problem. Okay, first of all, we will find out the theoretical air required. Okay, theoretical air required per kg of fuel. Okay, minimum theoretical air required. Okay, minimum theoretical air required formula, we know that is 100 by 23 into 8 by 3 C. Okay, 8 by 3 C plus 8 H2 plus, okay, 8 by 3 C plus 8 H2 plus S minus O2. Okay, we know that formula as earlier session. Okay, in this formula we substitute all these values. Carbon is 0.86 kg, hydrogen is 0.08 kg, and sulfur is, how much sulfur is given? 0.01 kg. Oxygen is 0.04 kg. Okay, 100 by 23, 8 by 3 C. Carbon, how much is given? 0.86 plus 8 into hydrogen, how much is given? 0.08 plus sulfur, how much is given? Sulfur is given 0.01 minus oxygen also given as 0.04. Okay, in this value we get the value of, that is 12.62 kg. okay, that is the value of theoretical air required. Again, air fuel ratio is equals to 12.62 divided by 1. Okay, 12.62 divided by 1, that is equals to 12.62:1. This is the air fuel ratio. Okay, in this manner we solve the theoretical air required. Okay, this is the one of the problem of the fuel combustion. Okay, thank you.